The latest jobless claims cast a stark spotlight on an emerging economic crisis in America, one that is likely to worsen in the weeks and months ahead. We're going to show a slice of how this is affecting individuals and families, and then look at what more should be considered by the government. Let's begin with a sampling of voices of workers who were laid off or furloughed. We asked you, our viewers, to describe the problems and choices you are facing.
My name is Dirk Bocolo. I live in Seattle, Washington. I was a operations manager for a luxury travel agency.
My name is Louis Vasquez. I essentially work in entertainment marketing in Los Angeles.
Tamika Anderson. I'm 38. I'm from West Philadelphia. I was janitorial. I cleaned. Cleaned the office, trash, vacuum.
My name is Lisa Ander, and I live in San Diego, California. I was a salesperson in a clothing store.
My name is Scott Saxon. I live in Kenmore, Washington. I work as a florist, and right now I'm a professional unemployment insurance caller upper.
I'm not going to be able to eat. I'm not going to be able to pay my gas, my electric, my rent, to buy the things that I need to buy on a day-to-day basis. Just to survive.
Even the smallest thing, like going to eat at McDonald's, becomes a luxury because you're like, oh, that 10 bucks could buy me, like, you know, cereal for a month or something.
We need food. We need electricity. We need to stay in our home. Those kinds of things. Then you just are looking at survival.
I've been laid off for a little, about 2.5 weeks now, and still have not been able to get any sort of employment insurance approved. I'm a type 1 diabetic, so the rising cost of insulin is something I've watched from the sidelines, really, because I've always had really good employer-provided healthcare. But I'm looking at this sudden cutoff where that won't be the case anymore, and kind of stockpiling as much insulin as possible now.
I can't pay any of my bills for this month. Definitely not next month. So I'm calling up like the banks and the credit card companies to, you know, see what we can do.
I never thought that I would ever have to apply for food stamps, whatever, welfare ever again. You know, that was something I did at a young age when I had my son. I vowed to, you know, keep a job and keep an income coming in so I wouldn't have to, you know, do those type things again.
I kept getting emails from the store. They kept pushing back the time frame. And then they were the ones that said, I think you need to look into unemployment. I hate to use the word ashamed, but I really was, because I thought I was stronger than that, more prepared than that. But the longer I started thinking of how long this would be and how maybe my daughter would be affected, that's when I made the shift. It's not just about me.
I've had conversations with my parents about having to probably move back home if I can't find work, or if I don't get approved for unemployment, which is kind of sad, because that, you know, no one ever wants to think, oh my gosh, I'm about to turn 50 years old and I'm going to have to move back home. But that's the reality of it, just to survive.
And we thank you for those comments you shared.